You know, I believe in clarity over agreement. My opponent is a public relations expert, and she's very good at it, as you just experienced. Tonight and over the campaign, I've heard some examples of some of the spin that's been used here. She likes to talk about Jefferson County being the fifth in graduation rates of the top 50 largest districts in the country. And that's all well and great, but what she doesn't tell you is that includes districts like Detroit, Houston, Chicago, New York, some of the worst districts in the country. What she should be telling you is that Jefferson County ranks 122nd in graduation rates in Colorado. We're not even in the top five in Colorado. Another thing she likes to talk about is the 10th grade math being better than Cherry Creek and Douglas County. But what she doesn't tell you are the actual numbers there. The 42% is what Jefferson County has. Cherry Creek is 39%, Douglas County is 41%, Colorado overall is 32%. Now, I was just a C student when I went through public schools, but to me, all of those are failing grades. And to say that we're doing good because we're doing better than the other failing districts, to me, is not something to be proud of. She likes to tout that 80% of our third graders are proficient at reading. You know, I like to look at that. I don't like to look at that, but I do look at that as 20% of our students are not proficient at reading at third grade, making them four times more likely to drop out of school before they graduate. That's not acceptable to me. That's 1,000 students right now, 1,000 third graders not proficient. And then Proposition 103. You know, as my opponent freely admits, she was very much part of the 383B mill levy back in 2008, I believe. And, you know, she's looking for more money for schools when we had 30% of our of the general fund already in savings at the time. And now she can't find the ability to say yes or no on 103. Everybody up here except her has made an opinion on that. I think the voters should deserve the right to know her position on that. And then there's the facility plan, which my opponent constantly downplays as it's not really there anymore. But you know, it is there. It's sleeping, and it's waiting for the new Board of Education to be elected. Would you please stop interrupting me? You interrupted me a lot of times. Yeah. You know, this is the kind of bullying. Would you let me finish? Is this how you're going to act when you're on the board? So, you know, my opponent, you know, until recently, she was I was interrupted. Would you please give me about 20 more seconds to finish what I was going to say? No. I appreciate that. Thank you so much. My opponent is quoted in the Columbine Courier in June 7, 2011. I think the school board, as difficult as it would have been, could have been more aggressive with school closures. Now, this is a $500 million plan that's put out by the district had put out there. I think the voters, again, deserve to know what her position is on that instead of her dancing around on it. Thank you so much for listening. Again, it is a clear choice here. The continued status quo or fresh ideas. I'd ask that you would consider supporting me. Thank you so much.